Hello class. So as I'm saying in my earlier video, we will definitely solve few numericals regarding radioactivity, basically because next part is that what I'm saying, that is nuclear energy. So first thing, suppose it is given complete. Suppose it is given. Acha, from exercise I'm doing. This is so given in book. Wait. I am solving exercise 12A. अच्छा सॉल्यूशन आई एम गिविंग हियर नाउ यू कॉपी फ्रॉम देयर सॉल्यूशन अच्छा आई एम डूइंग दिस वन कंप्लीट द फॉलोइंग न्यूक्लियर चेंजेस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सो कंप्लीट फॉलोइंग प्लीज डू कॉपी बिकॉज इन पीडीएफ आई विल गिव ओनली द क्वेश्चन फॉलोइंग न्यूक्लियर चेंजेस Okay, first thing what I will do, in book it is given, but since the additions are not same, so there is problem always. So we are having first one is P X A Q plus beta minus 1 0. Clear? Beta particle means the electron. So what I need to do, that I need to tell what is the atomic number of daughter nuclei Q and what is the mass number of daughter nuclei Q. Now which particle has been emitted here? As I can see here, the particle emitted is who? The particle emitted is here, that beta has been emitted. So beta emission means what? There is no change in mass number. So mass number will be same. So for Q it will remain A, and X will be increased by 1. So X plus 1. So if in exam it's like that, so this is the thing. Means you no need to write anything. Beta particle is there, means there will be increased in atomic number X plus 1, and there is no change in mass number. Now next one is there. Uranium 238 number 2 given, that is uranium 238 92 to thorium 234 90 plus, there is a dash plus energy. So what will be in this field in the blank? What will be in that blank? Now let's see what is the mass number here. Mass number is here 238, here mass number is how much? 234. Here atomic number is 92, here atomic number is 90. So atomic number has been decreased by 92 minus 92, and mass number also has been decreased. How much? 238 minus 234, how much? 4. So which particle? Mass number 4, atomic number 2, obviously alpha particle. So here will be alpha with mass number 4, atomic number 2. So this is the solution. Clear class? These things are very interesting. Only you need to remember that chart what I just show you. Okay, which particle after emission of which particle, what will happen? So next, let's go for the next one. Wait. Okay. Now next one is number 3 is given what? Number 3 is given P238 92. Then one alpha emission. So I am having Q. Then beta emission. I am having R. Then again a beta emission. I am having S. What I need to find out? Q, R and S, with obviously the atomic number and mass number. Now if first one, I am having alpha emission. So obviously there will be a decrease in two of the atomic number and minus four of mass number. So Q will be 234.90. Clear? Why? Because since alpha emission. Okay, since alpha emission, so it will be Z will be equal to what? Z will be equal to 92 minus 2, that is 90, and atomic number will be what? That is 238 minus 4, that is 234. Done. This is first thing. Now coming for the second one. So after alpha emission, what is happening? After alpha emission, we are having a beta emission. So beta emission means, so right now Q is this one. So from there beta. So beta particle means what? Beta particle means Z will be whatever right now, that will be plus 1. So 90 plus 1, Z will be 91. And atomic number will be since 234, because beta emission there is no change in atomic number. So R will be what? R will be 234.91. Done. Now again a beta emission. Yes. So beta emission means, say beta emission means Z will be again equal to 91 plus 1 means 92, and atomic number remain 234. So S will be 234.92. So these are the answer. Clear? So these are the answer. Like that you need to solve these things in exam also. Clear? Please do copy, because solution I will not give in copy. You know that better than me. So next one. Next question number 4 I am going. So question number 4, what I am having? Question number 4 I am having. There it is. X A Z, then alpha emission, then it will be, next one is X1, then one gamma emission happen, it is X2, then two beta means, then it is X3. Now I need to find out X1, X2 and X3. Clear? So first of all, since there is a alpha emission, so alpha emission means, alpha emission will be atomic number alpha decay. So atomic number equal to N minus 4, if I am not wrong. And sorry, mass number, mass number will be A minus 4, and atomic number equal to Z minus 2. Done. So what will be X1? X1 will be what? X1 will be Z minus 2 A minus 4. Now X1 is right now this one. Now from there gamma emission, gamma decay. Gamma decay means no change. So no change means, obviously there is gamma decay means, I can't write X1 like that. There will be a star. Means this is in excited state. That's why a gamma decay happening. So after gamma decay, it is now stable right now. So I am having X2 without any change. So X2 still right now, X2 is what? A minus 4 Z minus 2 without that star sign, because there is a stable, it is a stable nucleus right now. Now 2 beta. Now when 1 beta decay happening, then atomic number increase by 1. So 2 beta decay means atomic number will be increased by 2. So right now that atomic number will be, so right now X3's atomic number will be Z, minus 2 already there, plus 2 and A minus 4. So that is equal to X3 A minus 4 Z. So this is the answer, X3 A minus 4 and Z. So this kind of question will be there without any hesitation. You can do, I think, because all are very easy. Only you need to remember those alpha, beta, decays, that situation, what are these things. Thank you, please.